The heat is on as Republican candidate Donald Trump and the presumptive Democratic nominee Kamala Harris vie for the U.S. presidency this year. Recounting the racial events which occurred during the Trump presidency, concerns have been raised about the safety of Caribbean nationals residing in the United States. The attempted assassination of Trump and Joe Biden's decision to drop out of the presidential run have some political commentators scratching their heads.
I never support Trump. Never will. And so I was particularly upset, when Biden had that disastrous debate. I honestly sat down and I thought, that's it. He's in. Nobody's going to beat him.
Mr. Pitikin says, while Harris has gained attraction and favor of the Democrats, it is too early to speculate that her party will secure the presidential seat. Donald Trump, who has influence in the corporate sector, has the upper hand in campaign, which could shift the voting polls in his favor.
In politics, a week is a lifetime. You could get an October surprise that could affect either of them and push one above the other. So it's a little too early to tell. Democrats are generally supported by majority of people in the Caribbean for a variety of reasons. Social justice that they stand for, the fact that, we look at the people that basically run for the Democrats, and they seem to be more in line with the types of things that we as Caribbean people like.
Mr. Pitikin is hopeful that candidates will promote policies which will support diaspora members and other African groups in an effort to secure the polls this November.
While we've always liked Democrats, they have not always been good for the Caribbean. We have to remember, for example, that under Clinton, who I liked, we lost the banana preferential tariffs. He did nothing to help us, and he did everything to help Chiquita. At the same time, they tend to be very regulatory as a rule, and so they throttle and put more regulations on external investment from the states, and that affects people who perhaps might be interested in the Caribbean.
Mr. Pitikin encourages individuals from the diaspora to prepare themselves for the worst if the Trump administration is triumphant. He reminds locals to also prepare for local elections in 2026 to secure an accountable government in the future. For the DBS News World, Manasa Stanislaus reporting.